Hello, my name is Jun Lee. This video talk is about the paper High Precision Bootstrapping of RNS-CKKS Homomorphic Encryption using Optimal Minimax Polynomial Approximation and Inverse Sine Function. And this is a joint work with Yunsang Lee, Yongwoo Lee, Yongsik Kim, and Jongseon No. Here is the outline of our talk. Starting with the summary of our work, we will explain the RNS-CKKS fully homomorphic encryption scheme and its bootstrapping, which are mainly concerned in our work. Then we will suggest the main problem in RNS-CKKS bootstrapping in the next section. In the next two sections, we will explain the two new techniques, improved multi-interval remesh algorithm and composite function approximation by inverse sine function. First of all, let me summarize about our work in this slide. Our key question is how to reach high precision for the RNS-CKKS bootstrapping. To find the optimal minimax approximate polynomial for several piecewise and non-arithmetic continuous functions, we propose a robust, efficient, and high precision variant of multi-interval remesh algorithm that can be used practically. And to increase the capacity of the RNS-CKKS bootstrapping precision, we propose the composite function approximation by inverse sine function. While previous techniques can reach 27.2 to 30.3 bit precision of the bootstrapping, the new techniques can reach 32.6 to 40.5 bit precision of the bootstrapping, which is 5.4 to 10.2 bit precision improvement. So let me introduce the RNS-CKKS FH scheme. Fully homomorphic encryption scheme is an encryption scheme supporting arbitrary circuits or arbitrary arithmetic circuits on encrypted data. With the FH scheme, users having public keys can perform any operations on encrypted data, but they cannot access any information about the data. So FH scheme enables the clients to securely outsource the arbitrary computation about their private data. So among the FH schemes, the RNS-CKKS homomorphic encryption scheme is one of the most useful FH scheme now. Unlike other FH schemes for Boolean or integer data, the RNS-CKKS is optimized to deal with the real number data. The RNS-CKKS scheme supports various arithmetic operations on encrypted data, such as addition, multiplication, rotation, and complex conjugation. Since many practical systems use real numbers to represent data instead of integers or booleans, including machine learning systems, the RNS-CKKS FH scheme is an appropriate choice for this case. There is an essential homomorphic operation called the bootstrapping. In the process of homomorphic multiplication, the number of moduli related to ciphertext is reduced by one. In other words, each homomorphic multiplication consumes one RNS modulus. If we keep performing homomorphic multiplication, there is a moment when the ciphertext modulus is only one RNS modulus, where we cannot perform further homomorphic multiplication. In this situation, the bootstrapping is the solution. The bootstrapping operation refreshes this level zero ciphertext by raising modulus without changing messages. Since the modulus is raised, the further homomorphic multiplication can be performed. Especially for the advanced circuits having large multiplicative depth, the bootstrapping is inevitable. Now in this section, we suggest the main research problem of the conventional RNS-CKKS bootstrapping. Our main focus is the bootstrapping precision. Previous works regarding the RNS-CKKS bootstrapping only reports 15 to 20 bit precision of the bootstrapping. This precision is not sufficiently high in many practical situations. For example, Chan et al. Showed that when they used 16, 16-bit fixed point precision system in training machine learning model for MNIST dataset, the model failed to converge. Although there have been many techniques to use low precision fixed point system in machine learning now, it is pretty difficult to apply the techniques on homomorphically encrypted data. Further, only the fixed system point system is supported by the RNS-GKK scheme, rather than the floating point system that is generally used in many applications. And the fixed point system is generally less precise than the floating point system. So more precise RNS-GKK bootstrapping is needed in various applications. But previous works did not focus on the capacity of the bootstrapping precision. Thus, our key question is, how high precision can be supported by RNS-GKK scheme? And are there any further techniques to improve the bootstrapping precision? There are four main sub-processes in the RNS-GKK bootstrapping: mode raise and subsample, coif to slot, homomorphic model reduction, and slot to coif. Since the main obstacle for the bootstrapping precision is the homomorphic modular reduction, we focus on the homomorphic modular reduction in this paper. Before going to the next slide, note that by mode raise and subsum procedure, the plain text in the ciphertext is changed from delta 0 m to delta 0 m plus q 0 I, where delta 0 m is far less than q 0. The homomorphic modular reduction plays a role of removing Q0i part. The function to be evaluated in homomorphic modular reduction process can be represented like the blue graph. Since the messages are far less than Q0, the domain of the target function is the neighborhood of multiples of Q0. Previous works regard the target function as a part of a sine function and evaluate the approximate polynomial for sine function. We should note that regarding the target function as a sine function is also an approximation step. So there are two approximation steps in the homomorphic modular reduction process. In this work, we propose two new techniques to improve each approximation step. Polynomial approximation step is improved by improved multi-interval Ramez algorithm. And sine approximation step is improved by composite function approximation by inverse sine function. Now we will explain them in the next two sections. The first solution is the improved multi-interval Ramez algorithm, which is now described in this section. To approximate the piecewise modular reduction function, there has been several approximation techniques in previous works. Chen et al. Used the Taylor approximation with double angle formulas, and Chen et al. Used the Chebyshev interpolation method, and Han et al. Proposed a new Chebyshev interpolation method for the piecewise function. Although they all aimed at the best approximation in minimax aspect, which minimizes the maximum error, there are actually not the optimal solutions. So we raise a question. Is there any optimal solution? It is desirable to efficiently find the theoretically optimal minimax approximate polynomial for piecewise continuous function. So we found that there is a multi-interval Ramez algorithm for optimal minimax approximate polynomial of piecewise function. In the multi-interval Ramez algorithm, we obtain the polynomial alternating at the sum d plus 2 reference points from a system of linear equations. After all local extreme points for error function are searched, we choose new d plus 2 reference points among these points, satisfying local extreme value condition, alternating condition, and global extremum inclusion condition. Then these processes are repeated until we find the optimal polynomial. Then is it finished? If we just apply the LMS algorithm? Practically not yet. Unlike the ordinary cases, our target function is rather extreme case. The length of interval is very tiny. There are tens or even hundreds of approximation intervals. And the polynomial degree is somewhat high, and we need very high precision approximation. So we actually need a robust, efficient, and high precision variant of LMS algorithm performed well even for this extreme case. And this is a non-trivial problem. So the first point to be considered is when all local extreme points are found. The problem is that local extreme points are very, very dense, pretty dense, because of tiny intervals and high degree, and should be found with high precision for convergence of the LMS algorithm. Even one extreme point should not be missed, so not only is efficiency considered, but robustness for finding all local extreme points is also heavily considered. We propose efficient and robust two-mode search method for finding extreme points, which is a combination of scanning and binary search. So there are simple brute force scanning method is highly robust method, but it is extremely inefficient for high precision output. On the other hand, there is a kind of binary search method where each iteration choose the maximum point among three points and the step size is halved for the next iteration. This algorithm is a linear algorithm with the required bit precision, but it is robust only when the initial point is sufficiently close. Thus, we combine two methods. At first, we scan with a big step for rough local extreme point, and then we perform the binary search algorithm with high precision. We verified its robustness and efficiency even for high precision output. The second point to be considered is the global extremum inclusion condition for selection of the new reference points for next iteration. Global extremum inclusion condition means that a global extremum point should be included in the new reference point for each iteration. But the global extremum inclusion condition cannot effectively filter a good candidate of new reference points. So there are yet pretty many subsets of D plus 2 reference points satisfying these three conditions. For the best choice of new reference points for each iteration, we modify this condition to selecting D plus 2 reference points maximizing the absolute sum errors, called the maximum absolute sum condition. This table is the number of iterations when approximating the modular reduction function with uniformly detached initial reference points. As the table shows, it is numerically confirmed that the number of iterations is reduced when the maximum absolute sum condition is used. In the practical use, we use the initialization method similar to Hahn-et-al's method, and this leads to only 4 to 10 iterations. And we also propose a quasi-linear systematic elimination algorithm for robustly finding the new reference points satisfying the maximum absolute sum condition. So these graphs show the simulation results comparing Hahn-et-al's method and the improved multi-interval LMS algorithm. Note that the red graph is not only the result of our work, but also the theoretical bound for the approximation. We also showed that Hahn-et-al's approximation method is pretty practically useful in that their results are rather close to the bound, but there are yet 2 to 5 bits of precision gap. And the improved multi-interval LMS algorithm takes only less than 10 seconds. So it is more desirable to use the optimal minimax approximate polynomial when the improved multi-interval LMS algorithm is implemented. The second solution is the is The composite function approximation with inverse sine function is now described in this section. So let's look at the Honeydell's approximation method. The modular reduction function is regarded as a part of a sine function. To use the double angle formula of cosine function, they regard the sine function as a shifted cosine function. And H1 is the scaled cosine function, and H2 is the double angle formula of cosine function. So composition of H1 and L times double angle formula consists just the target sine function. The scaled cosine function is approximated by the polynomial. So we wanted to know the maximum precision supported by this method. So we tried to maximize the bootstrapping precision by adjusting parameters. So there are three parameters that affect the bootstrapping precision: degree of approximate polynomial, and ratio between scaling factor and the level zero modulus, and bootstrapping scaling factor. We said that this degree of approximate polynomial as high as possible, and the bootstrapping scaling factor as 60, which is the maximum bit length of RNS modulus in 64-bit computing system. And let's look at the second parameter in the next slide. So B is the ratio between scaling factor and level zero modulus, and delta diff is the log of B. We analyze the effect of B to the bootstrapping precision. The error E is the approximation error generated in homomorphic modular reduction, and this error is amplified with B when the scaling factor is reverted from Q0 to original scaling factor. So we can regard B times E as the resultant precision error of the bootstrapping. Since we set the degree of polynomial as high as possible, the error E is generated in the sine approximation for the modular reduction. Well, let's look at the tendency of the precision error when we change the value of log B. That is the delta diff. If delta diff is small enough, the error E is determined by the difference between the sine function and the modular reduction function. Since the sine x and minus x is proportional to x cubic for small x, so E is proportional to 1 over b cubic, and b times E is proportional to 1 over b squared. If delta diff is large enough, the error is determined by the approximation error from the homomorphic operations, which is somewhat constant. Thus, B times E is proportional to B. The graph between bit precision and log B can be represented as the figure. Thus, we have to set the delta diff as the threshold value of delta T to maximize bootstrapping precision. So reflecting this analysis, we measured the maximum bootstrapping precision by adjusting the parameters. Since the number of slots also affect the bootstrapping precision, we measured the precision for various number of slots. Then we found that 27.2 to 30.3 bit precision can be reached when Honeydell's approximation is used. Then the natural question is there any further technique to increase the maximum precision? In other words, the capacity of the bootstrapping precision. Our answer to the question is use the inverse sine function. So this shows the sine function approximating the modular reduction function, which cannot exactly evaluate the modular reduction function. We propose to compose this sine function with the inverse sine function. If we compose the inverse sine function, the composite function is like this graph. This composite function exactly evaluates the modular reduction function in the approximate domain, approximation domain. And thus, the approximation error between the modular reduction function and the sine function is completely removed, even when the approximation region is rather large. Further, note that the domain of the inverse sine function to be composed is only one interval, so the required degree is rather small. So we formally show the composite function approximation by inverse sine function in this slide. So we additionally approximate the inverse sine function in one interval. So we add the parameter of the degree of the approximate polynomial of the inverse sine function. So let's analyze the effect of the ratio between scaling factor and level zero modulus in the new situation. Unlike the previous case, the error E is always determined by the approximation error from the homomorphic operations, E0, even with the small delta diff. So B times E is always proportional to B. The graph is changed to the right side graph. Since the smallest delta diff is 3, because of the shape of the inverse sine function, the maximum precision is reached when delta diff is 3, which is higher than previous maximum precision without inverse sine. The table shows the comparison between the maximum precision without inverse sine and the maximum precision with inverse sine. The maximum precision of the bootstrapping is 32.6 to 40.5, which is improved by 5.4 to 10.2 bits compared to the previous bootstrapping. In other words, the precision error of the bootstrapping is reduced by 1 over 42 to 1 over 1176 times. So we could significantly enlarge the capacity of the bootstrapping precision of the RNS-CKK scheme, which makes the RNS-CKK scheme more appropriate to various situations requiring high precision. We conclude this talk in this slide for our key question of how to reach high precision for the RNS-CKK bootstrapping. We answer to the question by proposing the improved multi-interval Ramage algorithm and the composite function approximation by inverse sine function, and verify that the new techniques significantly improve the precision of the bootstrapping. Thanks for listening to our talk.